The French plan was to create at Dien Bien Phu, deep in hostile territory, a fortified base which would threaten the enemy's supply lines to Laos. Just as important, the fort might act as bait, luring the Viet Minh to attack with their best troops. The base could be supplied from Laos overland, and it could also be reinforced by air. The result they hoped for would be a set-piece battle that would allow superior French firepower to inflict a decisive defeat on the Viet Minh. In late November 1953, the Viet Minh's 316th Division advanced towards Laos, just as the French had expected. On November 20th, 800 elite French paratroopers, including a battalion of the Foreign Legion, were dropped near Dien Bien Phu. The reaction of the Viet Minh was to march elements of five more divisions towards the French camp. The French paratroopers at Dien Bien Phu quickly set about building fortifications and an airstrip. The idea was to mount offensive sweeps into the surrounding area, but soon the French were forced to think again. As the Viet Minh massed around the base, it became suicidal to venture far outside. Within 2 months, as the noose around Dien Bien Phu was drawn ever tighter, even a fighting withdrawal was no longer an option for the French. Even though his forces were now surrounded, the French commander, Colonel Christian de Castries, was completely confident. He was certain that aircraft could supply all the base's needs. Only enemy artillery posed any real danger. Some Viet Minh guns had begun to fire on the base, but the French were sure that only a handful could have been deployed in such difficult, hilly terrain. As for Viet Minh supplies and reinforcements, French air power would make sure they never reached Dien Bien Phu. Even though up to 100 French planes attacked Viet Minh supply routes every day, their efforts were having little effect. Too often, aircraft were grounded by the weather, and in any case, the Viet Minh were masters of camouflage and deployed huge numbers of anti-aircraft guns. In a massive effort over several months, General Voi Nien Giap, the Viet Minh commander, used 50,000 support troops to deploy more than 200 artillery pieces and anti-aircraft guns and a vast supply of ammunition around Dien Bien Phu. It was one of the most extraordinary feats of logistics in military history. To the 10,000 French now inside the base, the realization that they were surrounded by field guns and mortars and four deadly Soviet Katyusha rocket systems came as a dreadful shock. The French base at Dien Bien Phu had been sited on a flat valley floor. The airstrip and headquarters were the focus for the main battle position, a complex of five strongholds codenamed Françoise, Huguette, Claudine, Elion, Dominique. To break up attacks, strong points Anne-Marie, Gabrielle, Béatrice, and Isabelle had been created on a series of low hills. The base was manned by 9 infantry battalions and 2 crack parachute battalions. For support, there were artillery and mortars, Veit tanks, and fighter bombers. By early March 1954, 49,000 Viet Minh had deployed around Dien Bien Phu. 3 infantry divisions and 2 independent regiments were supported by the field guns of the 351st Heavy Division on the hills to the east and by heavy mortars on all sides. Anti-aircraft guns were secretly placed to cover the air routes in and out of the valley. As the weeks went on, Viet Minh artillery fire caused more and more casualties amongst the French at Dien Bien Phu. The fortifications had never been meant to withstand heavy artillery, and the French were horrified to find that neither counter-battery fire nor airstrikes were able to silence the enemy guns. They were too well dug in to hillside caves and bunkers and too well camouflaged. Any day now, the French knew, they would face an all-out enemy attack. It came on March 13th, 1954. The Viet Minh assault began with a massive artillery bombardment. French gun positions in the central area were hammered. In 3 days after repeated human wave assaults and hopeless French counterattacks, the Viet Minh took the northern strong points of Beatrice, Gabriel, and Anne-Marie. The loss of their northern outposts cost the French 1,500 men. The Viet Minh had suffered much worse, nearly 7,000 killed and wounded, but they had proved that the French defenses could be overcome. They had also closed down the base's main airfield for good. The French would now have to depend on parachute drops for supply and reinforcement. After a 2-week lull, the Viet Minh renewed their offensive. The battle raged for a fortnight, with the French contesting every foot of ground. In the end, shocking Viet Minh casualties forced General Giap to pause. Meanwhile, the French situation was getting desperate. Ammunition and food was short, and 3,000 wounded were trapped inside the base in appalling conditions. With disaster looming on the battlefield, the French appealed to the United States for help. There was a plan to use American bombers and even to drop 4 nuclear weapons, which was codenamed Operation Vulture. But Eisenhower ruled out any American military intervention unless other allies took part. None agreed to help. The French at Dien Bien Phu were to be left to their fate. Although the outpost Isabelle was still in French hands, it was by now cut off from the central stronghold at Dien Bien Phu. Besieged by the Viet Minh 304th Division, Isabelle was under heavy artillery fire. Incredibly, although attacked time and time again, the post would hold out until the very end of the battle. In the central sector, strong point Francoise had been abandoned, and the Viet Minh had captured Dominique along with part of Helian and Huguette. However, there were two new strong points, Sparrowhawk and Juneau. Meanwhile, the Viet Minh had adopted new tactics in an attempt to reduce their terrible casualties. Secretly, they had dug more than 50 miles of trenches, creeping right up to the French perimeter. The final Viet Minh assault came on the night of May 1st, 1954. After a massive barrage, the Viet Minh infantry hit the remaining bunkers of Huguette and Helian. In spite of fierce French resistance, positions fell one by one until, on the evening of the sixth day, a huge mine demolished part of Helian and its last bunkers were overrun. At 5:30 p.m. on May 7th, 1954, Vietnamese forces occupied the French command post, and the French commander ordered his troops to cease fire. It was 55 days to the minute since the battle had begun. At Dien Bien Phu, 3,000 French troops had been killed and 8,000 wounded. The Viet Minh had suffered much worse, with more than 8,000 dead and 12,000 wounded. But for them, the outcome had still been a triumph. On the eve of an international conference on Indo China, they had shattered France's resolve to carry on the war. The Viet Minh expected that the negotiations at Geneva would open the way for full Vietnamese independence and a major role for them in running the new country. In fact, the Viet Minh negotiators faced bitter disappointment. Behind closed doors, Chinese Prime Minister Zhou Enlai struck a deal with the French and forced Ho Chi Minh to agree that the country be divided into two zones. There was to be a ceasefire, but there would be no immediate decision about who was to control Vietnam until elections settled the future.